oh my gosh, sweating my ass off. You're amazing. Oh my gosh. No, it's fine. I don't want to steal your battery. Thank you. To have like a personal fan. Oh, I already turned it on. Yeah. So I talked to you right before Cleveland Abduction came out, and I feel like everyone's seen you grow so much on screen from, you know, a decade ago when you're acting to now. You've taken a lot of challenging roles, from Pennsylvania to this new role in Cleveland Abduction. Why do you like to choose more gritty roles like that?
I think it's a misconception that I choose things. I'm still in a place where I have to audition. So it's not like I just go and I read a script and I pick a role. You know, once you know, there's different levels. When you start, you're auditioning with them, then you go to the next level, you're auditioning with them, then it's like, this, before you know it, you're auditioning next to some of the greatest, you know, because it's hard. You're fighting for roles for women, and good roles, you know, that aren't just sort of in the background and this and that. And they choose me, you know. Yeah, I've been very, very stereotyped. There was a time I rebelled against it, and I said no to so many things because I was upset. But then I was like, you know what? I'm a working actor, and my dreams came true, and I have to do it like this, and I'm gonna do it different every time, and I don't know, I get to experience a lot of great things, like meeting Michelle Knight, you know, who goes as Lily now, but becoming a very good friend of mine. So.
And okay. It's worked out so well for you, yeah.
Thank you
so much, and thank you for the fan.